Last session, we had a discussion related to gradient descent for linear regression. And whatever we have discussed so far, that was related to simple linear regression, or we may say it is univariate linear regression, wherein we are having only one feature in our data set for training. Today, we are going to talk about multiple linear regression. So let's recall back what is the difference in simple linear regression and multiple linear regression. In simple linear regression, we are having only one feature or only one independent variable. And we are having one dependent variable. So in simple regression, we are having only one independent variable x, and we are having one dependent variable y. So we have seen various examples of this kind. So we have seen earlier in our housing price data set, only one feature we were considering, that is size of the house, and based on size of the house we were predicting the price of the house. So size of the house is my x, that is independent variable, and it is a single feature, right? And based on that we were predicting the output y, that is the price of the house. So this is simple regression, or sometimes it is called as univariate linear regression. Now we are going to focus upon multiple regression. So what is multiple regression? In multiple regression, we are having more than one features, more than one independent variables, or more than one features in our feature vector. So one house is not being described with only one feature or property, that is size of the house. Instead, we are having several such attributes. Those are describing the house, and based on all those features, we are going to predict the price of the house y. So no doubt the dependent variable is only one, that is price of the house, but the features or the independent variables are more than one. So today we are going to talk about such kind of multiple regression, right? So let us see first the simple regression that we have gone through, and then we'll extend this to multiple regression. So this is our scenario. So housing price data set we have. We are having here a single feature, that is size of the house, denoted here as x. And based on that, we would like to predict the price. So in our training data set, initially, we are having both these values available, right? We know input and also we know output y, price of the house, right? Now, to represent this pictorially, there is only one independent variable, it is possible to depict it using a two-dimensional plot. So on x-axis, we are having independent variable, that is size of the house, which is a single feature, which is an only feature in our data set. And on y-axis, we are having the dependent variable, that is price. As we know, these are actually the examples in our training data set with known outputs. So based on these x and y values, we may plot these data points in this space, right? And following this simple regression, and by optimizing the hypothesis by making use of gradient descent, it is possible now for us, we know how to get the hypothesis that fits my data. So this is my hypothesis, and in fact this hypothesis is actually of this form, mathematical form. So this hypothesis is represented like h theta x equal to theta 0 plus theta 1 x, where this x is my only feature that I'm having. So this x is in our case size of my house, right? And based on the size of my house, I'll be predicting the prices of the future data points, those may come in. Okay, how to come up with this theta 0 theta 1 we have gone through by making use of gradient descent, right? So we have applied gradient descent for simple linear regression, and now we know how to come up with this theta 0 theta 1 values for the hypothesis, right? Now we are going to extend this concept of simple regression to multiple regression. So what we mean by multiple regression, we are having more than one features or independent variables instead of one feature. And in real world scenario, always we are not having only one feature that is describing the object or that is describing the thing. Instead, usually we are having more number of features, those are describing the object, right? So let us go through few notations and then we'll try to come up with the expression, okay, for multiple linear regression. So once again here, small m denotes the number of examples in my training set. Small m denotes the number of examples in my training set. Small n denotes the number of features in my feature vector. Small n denotes the number of features in my feature vector. This capital X denotes the feature vector for training example, right? And this XJ superscript I, or in other way we may read it like XI subscript J, it is the value of feature J in ith training example. We know this notation. If I am using superscript I, this denotes that we are dealing with ith training example. So if I am having XI subscript J, this means that I am dealing with a feature, jet feature in ith feature vector. So ith feature vector is meant for ith training example. So I am having ith training example and I am having ith feature vector, and out of that feature vector we are accessing the value of jet feature. That is what we mean by this notation XI subscript J, right? Let us see all those notations, how we are using those notations with example. So let us consider once again the housing price data set, but now instead of having only one independent variable, that is size, we are having now a feature vector. So we are having 1, 2, 3 and 4, 4 features, right? Those describe one house. So what are those features? We are having size of the house, we are having number of bedrooms in the house, we are having number of floors, and also we are having one more attribute, that is age of home in years. Okay, and based on these 4 attributes, the price of the house is decided, right? So this is our training data set that we have. Okay, so now let us relate all those different values with these notations. Okay, so what is n number of examples? So right now, how many examples I am having in my data set? Yes, anybody? M is number of examples. So how many examples right now we are having in our training data set? What is the value of M?
4.
It is 4, correct.
4.
L, which is number of features. Those are describing one house. So how many features we are having here? What is 4. Value of L?
4.
4. Once again, 4. So number of features describing one house, 4. Right? So n, small n equal to 4. Now what is this x? X is actually the feature vector for training example. X is the feature vector for training example. So obviously this feature vector will include 4 values for 4 features. So as n equal to 4, right? My feature vector will have 4 values for 4 features. Okay? So, I may say this is one feature vector, right? Whatever I have denoted here using this red rectangle, these are the 4 features belonging to one feature vector. And this is my feature vector associated with second example. And that is why I'll denote this feature vector as X superscript 2. So this superscript denotes the number of examples. So this is second example. That is why we are denoting this vector as X superscript 2. So X superscript 2 denotes the second feature vector, entire vector. This vector consists of 4 values, 4 features, right? So if I want to depict this feature vector in actually the vector form, it is a column vector here. This is a column vector. So X2 is denoted as 1, 4, 1, 6, 3, 2, 40. So this is my first feature in the feature vector X2. This is the second feature. This is the third feature. And this is the fourth feature in my feature vector. So feature vector is a column vector, right? And this superscript denotes the example, right? For which this feature vector is described. So these features, individual features in my feature vector are described like this. See here how to denote. This is my feature number 1 belonging to the second feature vector. So I'll be denoting it like X21, subscript is 1. Subscript 1 denotes it is the first feature. And superscript 2 denotes first feature in second vector. First feature in second training example. Similarly, this 3 is denoted as X22. So this is the second feature in second training example. This 2 is denoted as X23. So this is third feature in second training example. And similarly, we are denoting this 40 as X24. So it is fourth feature in my second training example. Right? Have you understood? Any doubts so far? Please tell me how to denote. Please tell me how to denote this 36. Yes, anybody? How to denote this 36?
X 4 4.
This is X. Yes, X 4. So superscript 4 and subscript is also 4. So what does this mean? This means that this is the fourth feature in my fourth training example. So simple. So associated with all those feature vectors now, we are having this output, that is price. So obviously this price is denoted like Y superscript 1, right? Y superscript 2 and so on. So what does this mean? Y superscript 1 indicates that this is the label or this is the output, actual output associated with first training example. Y superscript 2 denotes that this is the output associated with the second training example and so on. Got it? Yes, may I proceed?
Yes, ma'am.
Fine. So yes. With these notations in mind, now we are going to proceed. Okay? With the expressions now. So in simple regression, as we had only one feature, right? We had only one feature. And that is why our hypothesis was really very simple and in the form of a line. So in simple regression, we had the hypothesis of the form h theta x equal to theta 0 plus theta 1 x. X being the only feature describing our training example, right? Now, in multiple regression, we are having more than one features, right? So obviously, my hypothesis will look like something like this. See here what we have. H theta x equal to theta 0 plus theta 1 x1 plus theta 2 x2 plus theta 3 x3 and so on. So what are those x1, x2, x3? Those are actually the features of one example under consideration. And this capital X, this is a vector notation. Whatever you are looking at, this capital X. So this is a vector notation. So instead of my hypothesis, here my hypothesis is the function of a single variable x. But here my hypothesis is a function of a vector now. And this vector comprises of many features, n number of features, x1, x2, x3 up to xn. Right? So in multiple regression, we are denoting our hypothesis in this form. H theta x is equal to theta 0 plus theta 1 x1, theta 2 x2 plus theta 3 x3 plus so on. So number of features. So here, once again, I'm repeating x1, x2, x3 are the features of a single example under consideration. And this hypothesis is parameterized once again by theta. Right? Now, may I proceed? Have you understood this?
Yes, ma'am.
Fine. In general now, in general, right? We are having this as the hypothesis for multiple regression, h theta x equal to theta 0 plus theta 1 x1 plus theta 2 x2, so on up to theta n xn. So I'm having n number of features in my feature vector. Okay? But in general, we may write for mathematical convenience and for the convenience of notations. In fact, we are introducing one more term here, or rather one more feature here, right? And we are letting always that feature x0 equal to 1. So we are just rewriting this hypothesis h theta x like h theta x equal to theta 0 x0 plus theta 1 x1 plus theta 2 x2, so on up to theta n xn, provided this value of x0 is 1. This value of x0 is 1. Right? This is only for the convenience of notations. Right? Let us derive now two vectors. So capital X is the vector, my feature vector. Capital X is my feature vector. So if I collect all those features together, I'll be having this feature vector denoted here as x0, x1, so on up to xn. Right? If I collect all those parameters together, I'll be having here once again a column vector theta. And this vector theta comprises of the parameters theta 0, theta 1 up to theta n. Right? So what we have done? Simply we have collected the features in a feature vector and the parameters in the parameter vector. So we are having now two vectors. X is the feature vector and theta is the parameter vector. Both are column, both are column vectors of size n plus 1. So how many elements we have in these two vectors? We are having n plus 1 elements. Do you agree with me?
Yes.
Right? So now, with all those considerations, we are coming with a simplified expression for our hypothesis. And this hypothesis can now be represented as h theta x equal to theta transpose x. H theta x is equal to theta transpose x. So what is this theta transpose now? Here I am having this theta as the column vector of size n plus 1. Whenever I say it is theta transpose, it becomes a row vector of size n plus 1. Right? So the row vector of size n plus 1 multiplied with, right, or there is a product, dot product of theta transpose and x. So theta transpose is now my row vector of size n plus 1 with a dot product of this vector, column vector x, once again of the size n plus 1. So ultimately this theta transpose x will give me this expression theta 0 x 0 plus theta 1 x 1 plus theta 2 x 2 and so on. So product of this theta transpose x will give me this expression theta 0 x 0 plus theta 1 x 1 plus theta 2 x 2 up to theta n x n. Right? So we have come up with this simplified expression for our hypothesis h theta x equal to theta transpose x. Right? Any doubts so far? What we have done to come up with this expression? Simply we have added one more feature here, x0. Right? And we have set the value of x0 equal to 1. So always this x0 in any feature vector will have value 1. And then it's a feature. Right? Any doubt so far? Yes. May I proceed?
Yes, ma'am.
Fine. Now, let us collect all the expressions together along with our cost function, and then we'll see how to apply the gradient descent to multiple linear regression. So our hypothesis is of the form h theta x equal to theta transpose x equal to theta 0 x 0 plus theta 1 x 1, so on up to theta n x n. So this is our hypothesis. What are the parameters here? Please note here x 0 is 1. And we are having both these vectors with dimensionality n plus 1, n plus 1 element vectors. Above parameters, we are having n plus 1 parameters, theta 0, theta 1, theta 2, up to theta n. And this will denote a vector, parameter vector theta. Right? Now, for this multiple linear regression or cost function for this hypothesis would be like this. J of, it is now the function of theta 0, theta 1 up to theta n. So our cost function now will be the function of all the parameters. So J of theta 0, theta 1 up to theta n. So we denote this cost function as J of theta, where this theta is a vector, right? It is not a single feature, but it is a vector, right? So J of theta is my cost function now, where this theta denotes this feature vector. And it is given as 1 divided by m summation over I equal to 1 to m h theta xi minus yi square. Here we are having 1 divided by 2m. 1 divided by 2m summation over I equal to 1 to m h theta xi minus yi square. Please note here, this x is my vector and not the single feature. Right? So this is our cost function now for multiple regression. And what is the goal? Goal obviously is to minimize this cost function J of theta. Right? Simply, the theta is now a vector of several parameters, n plus 1 parameters. And we would like to come up with the optimal values of the parameters such that J of theta is minimum. The cost is minimum. So once again, to minimize this cost function J of theta, we are going to apply gradient descent. Right? So once again, simply our gradient descent will look like this. So we are repeating the process. So we are updating every parameter theta j with this expression. So we are simultaneously updating all the values of thetas. How? We are having the expression theta j is equal to theta j minus alpha into the partial derivative of j. Please note here, this j is now the cost function of the several parameters theta 0, theta 1 up to theta n. Right? And obviously, here j varies from 0 to n. So we need to update theta 0, theta 1, theta 2 up to theta n. So n plus 1 updates we need to perform. Right? And how we are going to update all those thetas? With this expression. Old value of theta minus alpha, that is my learning rate, into the partial derivative of j with respect to that theta value. So theta j equal to theta j minus alpha into partial derivative of j with respect to theta j. Right? So this is our gradient descent algorithm that we would like to apply to minimize our cost function j. Right? Any doubts so far? Yes. May I proceed?
Yes, ma'am.
Fine. So now, let us look at the gradient descent algorithm for simple linear regression and multiple linear regression. So we know the simple linear regression algorithm using the gradient descent. So in simple linear regression, we had only one feature and we had only two parameters, theta 0 and theta 1. And that is why we mentioned the simple linear regression algorithm with gradient descent to update the parameters like this. Repeat until convergence, theta 0 equal to theta 0 minus alpha into 1 divided by m, summation over I equal to 1 to m, h theta xi minus yi, theta 1 equal to theta 1 minus alpha into 1 divided by m, summation over I equal to 1 to m, h theta xi minus yi into xi, right? So this is the expression to update my theta 0 and this is the expression to update my theta 1. In simple linear regression, we had only two parameters and these are the expressions. Those will help us to update these values of theta 0 and theta 1. So this is actually the partial derivative of j theta 0 theta 1 with respect to theta 0. And this is the partial derivative of j of theta 0 theta 1 with respect to theta 1. So we have gone through this algorithm, simple linear regression algorithm. Now, the gradient descent is being applied to multiple linear regression. So obviously, we need to look at algorithm for multiple linear regression. So the multiple linear regression algorithm will look like this. See here, we are having update rule for theta j in general. So theta j equal to theta j minus alpha into 1 divided by m, summation over I equal to 1 to m, h theta xi minus yi into xji. So, what we have done here, anybody who can explain me this expression? Anybody who can explain this expression? What we are trying to do? Yes?
Derivative term, I mean.
So, yes, of course, this is a derivative term, right? But what actually we are trying to do here? In general, in simple linear regression, we dealt with these two parameters separately. And we have written the partial derivatives for theta 0 and theta 1 separately. Okay, because we had only two parameters in simple linear regression. But in multiple linear regression, we are using the generalized approach, right? So in general, we are writing the expression to update theta j. So if you look at, we are having this expression that is similar to this expression. Only thing is, we have added here this subscript j denoting the jth parameter. And accordingly, we are making use of here that particular feature value, jth feature value of ith sample. Right? Jth feature value of ith sample. because we are having more than one features. Okay, so see here how we have written this expression. Theta j is equal to theta j minus alpha into 1 divided by m summation over I equal to 1 to m h theta xi minus yi into x ij. So we are dealing with jth feature of ith example, right? Jth feature of ith example. So this is the generic way to write the update rule for every parameter theta j. So no doubt this is my derivative term for j of theta. So theta comprises of now theta 0, theta 1 up to theta n. So this theta is my vector, parameter vector, right? And this particular expression is the partial derivative of my cost function j of theta. Correct? So in multiple linear regression, if I am having more than one features, I'll be making use of this particular algorithm to come up with the optimal values of thetas, right? So this is how actually we are going to make use of gradient descent for multiple linear regression, right? Obviously here also we need to update all theta j's simultaneously. Okay, so I hope you must have understood the difference in simple linear regression and multiple linear regression. May I proceed? Yes.
Yes, ma'am.
Fine. I'm going to provide you few practical tips while implementing this linear regression. Maybe it is simple linear regression or maybe it is multiple linear regression. So while implementing linear regression with gradient descent, we need to take care of few things. So while implementing, we need to take care of few important parameters and the values of these parameters or the features, and that is why I'm going to provide you some practical hints or tricks, right? In the video that I'm going to upload for practical implementation of linear regression, we are going to make use of these kinds of tips. Okay, so the first practical tip is regarding feature scaling. Feature scaling. So what we mean by this feature scaling? So as we mentioned, in multiple linear regression, one object is being described with many number of features. And obviously it may happen that range of the values for every feature is different. I'll repeat. We are describing one example with many number of features, right? And it may happen that the range of values for every feature is different, right? Say for example, if I'm having feature x1 that is describing size of the house, then the range of values for this feature x1 may be from 0 to 2000 square feet. 0 to 2000 square feet. So the value for this feature x1 will range in between these two values, these two limits, 0 to 2000. That is size of my house. But if we are having the second feature x2 as the number of bedrooms, then the range of values for this feature x2 is within this range, 1 to 5. So I may have one bedroom, two bedrooms, three, four, or five. So minimum value is one, maximum value is five. Right? So these features, these are two features in my feature vector, describing one example. Right? But these features are having different ranges of their values. Right? Now, practically, if we want the quick convergence of our algorithm, then it is ideally we should have similar range of values for the features. Similar range of values for the features. And that is why we need to scale our features if they are having very different ranges. Right? So if my features are having very different ranges with respect to the values associated, then for quick convergence of the algorithm, what we need to do is we need to scale our features. So we need to bring all those features into the similar range, into the similar scale. Right? So how to do that? And what happens if they are having different scales or different ranges? Say, for example, we have denoted here diagrammatically what happens if the features are having different ranges. Okay, so here we are having associated parameters theta 1, theta 2 with respect to these features x1 and x2. And we are having this cost function plotted here, g of theta. So we may look at it like these are the contours. So this is a contour plot that we are describing for j of theta. And now if you look at this contour plot, then you may observe that these contours are very tall. These are stretched and these are very much skewed. Right? So these contours are skewed, these are tall and skinny, and if we are having such kinds of contours, then obviously if I am having initial theta 1, theta 2 parameter somewhere over here, then the convergence is I need to reach to this center so that I can get the optimal values of my parameters, right? So if I am having such kinds of skewed contours, then it may happen that it will take much more time. So I may go here, 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 here. So lots of different steps we need to follow to reach to this particular minimum. Right? So if I am having the different values for my features, right? If these features are not scaled properly, what will happen? I'll be having associated theta 1, theta 2 values like this. So I'll be having the cost function which looks like this, which is very skewed, tall and skinny. And if we are performing gradient descent with respect to this j of theta, then what will happen is it will just take more time to converge, right? So if we would like to converge my gradient descent faster, what we should do is we should scale the features. And what we mean by that and how to do that? So we are having here method number one to scale the features. So we are going to divide the feature value by the maximum in the range. Say, for example, I am having this x1, that is one feature. So whatever is the size divided by the maximum value of that feature, that is 2000. So simply I am normalizing this feature value x1. So x1, whatever is the actual size, divided by 2000, that is the maximum value. So divide the feature value by maximum in the range, right? Similarly, if this is my x2, another feature, number of bedrooms, so that is the actual value of the feature divided by the maximum value for that feature, that is 5. So this is how I'll be scaling my feature x1 and x2, right? And if I use such kinds of scaled values, then I'll be having the pattern of contours similar to this. So I'm having more circular contours. And if I'm having such kind of a pattern, my algorithm will converge very fast, right? So feature scaling helps us in quick convergence of our gradient descent. And this is one way of feature scaling, right? In the next session, we are going to look at few such practical tips, right, to implement regression with gradient descent. Okay, so I'm going to conclude this session today.